If you want to tweak your blockchain towards a more decentralized version, more scalable version, or a more secure version, you need to tweak some properties of the blockchain. So you can do this in four main categories, and to visualize it, the ecosystem created a crypto flower, also known as the blockchain spectrum or the blockchain flower, or originally based on the central bank or on the money flower. Bottom line, we will note down the source. You can read the original article and you can find the original crypto flower, so you can zoom in on the different properties that each leaf encompasses. We have four different type of leaves. Keep in mind that every time these leaves are called differently. So we've got distributed systems, also known sometimes as consensus leaf. That's leaf number one. We've got the second leaf. I'm doing it correctly. This is always described the same in all the different models. The cryptography leaf, this is the second leaf. We've got the third leaf, sometimes called governance, sometimes called politics. I prefer the governance leaf, but you can write down whatever you like, of course. And the last one, also a very interesting one, just as interesting as the others, of course, is number four, the economy / game theory leaf. I prefer game theory, by the way, although I write down economic leaf, and blah, 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 blah. Within each leaf, you have different properties. So let's say, for example, we take the cryptography leaf, the second one. You can have multiple different kinds of hashes. Or if we're talking about the distributed leaf, you can have proof of work, proof of stake. You can go centralized. If you're talking about the game theory, you can have 21 million bitcoins or an uncapped supply like Ethereum, where there's no limitation in the amount of cryptocurrencies. Of course, it's a huge difference when you tweak each of these parameters within a leaf. So let's just say that, for example, you increase the block size from 1 MB to 2 MB, or if you switch from proof of stake to proof of work, or if you go from SHA-256 algorithm to a CACAC in Ethereum, or if you go from BIPs in Bitcoin to a centralized team, or 39 of the world's biggest companies in Hashgraph, different properties in each leaf will lead to different blockchains, which will lead to different use cases. Main key takeaway is remember these four different kinds of leaves. If you tweak the properties in these leaves, you will move gradually in the scalability trilemma, also three balls described in previous course, eventually leading up to an entirely different blockchain and a different use case. So next sessions, we will discuss each of these leaves in more detail so that you know a bit what you can expect. Not only will we describe these sessions, we will also describe the hardware that runs it, etc., etc. So it's going to be an awesome course, in my humble opinion. And hopefully you will survive the very first part, the cryptography, which is quite a challenging one, of course, because of the mathematics. But I promise you, if you stick together, if you ask each other questions, or if you ask us questions, if you got stuck in the Slack or in the comments, we will get you through it. And eventually, by the end of level two, you will understand this crypto flower, you will understand the hardware, you will understand the software, and you will be able to explain what a blockchain is on a birthday party.